Hello, manifestors. Five crucial reasons why it's hard to manifest your SB. After having helped hundreds of people manifesting their SB, I thought it was time to do a list of the five most common reasons why it's hard for you to manifest your SB. So stay tuned until the end of this video if you want to know what they are and therefore be able to avoid those reasons so you can finally manifest your SB easily and effortlessly. If you are new here, please subscribe to my channel, like the video, comment, and share the video so more people like you will know once and for all what they should not do and what they should do instead to manifest their SB. My name is Sylviane. I am a manifesting coach. I do one-on-one coaching and email coaching. I have a podcast based on the law of assumption, the teaching of Neville Goddard, every Tuesday on all the podcast platforms. I also have a blog every Thursday. And I have a free Facebook group. It's a private group, but it's free, and a VIP paid group where I do a Q&A live every Wednesday. And Andrezza, who is a wonderful coach in my team, is creating knockout challenges to improve your manifesting skills. And all the links are down below this video in the description box. So, manifesting your specific person, is it harder than manifesting anything else? Well, by law, no, not at all. So, why is it harder for most people out there? Because you are making it so. And you are making it harder because of the reasons that we are going to discuss today. So, reason number one, you need them too much. I don't know if you've analyzed your life, if you've done reverse engineering, as I always tell people to do, because it will give you all the answers about how you manifest and why you manifest it. But if you have done that, you may have noticed that you do not manifest easily anything that you need. It sounds very cruel, I know, but you do not ever manifest what you really need. Because even if you need something desperately, you have to find a way that you just let go, that you just don't even really care so much about anymore in order to manifest it. I know it happened to me. There were some things that I desperately needed, and I can assure you that while I needed those things, I never manifested them. It's only when I gave up, when I said, you know what? I don't even care anymore. I give up. I don't even want this life anymore. You know, I'm ready to check out. That's when I manifested that one thing that I really needed. Did I manifest it when I really, really wanted it? Really, really needed it? No. I did when I gave up, when I said, enough is enough. I don't care anymore. I'm ready to check out or else. And that's when I dropped the curtain of neediness, so to speak, that what I needed so much finally started to appear in my life. So it's the same thing with a specific person. When you need them so much, when you think about them 24/7, when they are the center of your world, when you feel that your life has no meaning without them, unfortunately, as per the law, you're not going to be able to manifest them. Because as the operant power we create by what we feel. And the law is impartial. The subconscious mind is impartial. So there is no such law that says, oh, I'm feeling sorry for you, therefore I'm gonna give it to you. The law does not work like that. All right? The way it works is whatever you feel within, you are manifesting it as a mirror. So when you feel a huge need for something, it mirrors that need. So you create more need out there. You do not create the fill for the need. You create the vacuum, the gap for that need, because you create that need as a reflection of your feeling. This is why when you truly, truly, truly need that SP, I promise you, they're not coming. So you need to find a way to not need them so much anymore. It doesn't mean that you have to not want them, but you have to not need them. And the best way to get to that level is to work on your concept of self. Because when you need someone too much, it's all about your concept of self. And by the way, if you need an SP too much, you are going to need them still when you have them. And that feeling, even if you do manage to manifest them, that feeling of neediness while you have them, trust me, it's going to manifest them in getting away from you again. So this is something you must do. You must work on yourself in order not to need your SP, your specific person anymore. Because as long as you do, you're not going to be able to manifest them. And even if you did, you wouldn't be able to keep them. Because that neediness comes from you. It comes from a lack within you. It comes from some issues with your self-concept. Number two, you think that they are outside of you and that they have their own free will. As long as you feel that people are outside of you and that they have their own free will, I don't even know how you can manifest them. You're going to make this very, very difficult for you. Because how in the world, someone that is outside of you with their own free will, doing their own things, is going to come to you? As long as you have this belief, it's gonna make it hard for you to manifest them. But the truth is that nobody is outside of you. We are all one. As Neville said, everything is God and there is only one God. So what does that mean? It means that while we seem to have different bodies, we even seem to be different things. There are humans, there are animals, there are trees out there. Whatever it is that you see out there, it's only one God. God is everything and anything. So your specific person is not separated from you. And what you think about yourself and what you think about them, they reflect that. They will unconsciously, completely unconsciously, reflect that. This is why when I decided to manifest my SP, when I assumed that it was mine, without doing any affirmations, without doing any sats, without doing anything but assuming that he was mine, 10 days later, he had a dream about me where I was his. How in the world did that happen? Because my SP wasn't separated from me. And since I assumed that he was mine, that belief, that feeling, that knowing, that assumption went to his subconscious mind, and in his dream, he was what I assumed him to be. Same thing with the free will. Free will, as Neville said several times, it's just a big illusion. We believe that people out there have free will, but they don't. They are just a reflection of us, a reflection of our thoughts, a reflection of what we believe about ourselves, about other people, and about the world in general. They are just a reflection. But when it comes to your world, people don't have free will. They can only project back onto you what you feel within. So this is the reason number two, guys, why you feel it so hard to manifest your SP, is that you do not remember or feel or know or believe any of that. What you truly believe is that your SP is out there, wherever they are, and that they do their own things and have their own free will, and that they have nothing to do with you, basically. If you believe that at any level, sometimes more or less, but if you believe that, it's going to be very hard for you to manifest them. So instead, recall everything I just said, and this is going to help you tremendously to manifest your SP. Number three, maybe a little similar to number two, but not exactly. So I put it as number three. So number three is, they are not available. They don't want you. So something that I noticed is that a lot of you, while manifesting an SP, you have the background belief that, after all, if they're not here by now, they probably don't want you. Because if they did, they would be here by now, right? Or they're not available. They are very busy with work or whatever is going on in their lives. If you believe that, you're not going to be able to manifest them. If you believe that they're not available, that they don't want you in any way, shape, or form, they're not going to want you. Because again, they have no choice. They are going to act as you assume. If you assume that about them, that's what's going to happen. They are going to conform to your assumption. So in this case, there is that issue with the third party. Many, many of you have a third party. And you believe, because of this third party, therefore they can't be yours. But unfortunately, as long as you believe that, they won't be yours, because you believe that the third party means anything. Well, again, I had a third party from day one. But did I ever thought that this third party meant anything to me? No, I did not. And that's why she was gone in no time at all. Because I never calculated her. She was never an issue for me. Because I understood, as God of my reality, if I have a desire, I can have it. And I do not need to mess up with 3D stuff, because they don't matter. So every time you feel that your SP is not available or doesn't want you because of anything, because they are in another country, because they have a 3P, because they are busy, because whatever. Every time you believe that, well, I'm sorry guys, but if this is one of your beliefs and you don't have your SP anymore, well, there you go. That's why you don't have your SP anymore. So cut that out. If you have that belief that they're not available or that they don't want you because of any of the reasons that I mentioned or more, cut it out. Because this is preventing your SP to be with you right now. Number four, you keep looking at 3D for proof. This is a huge one. So I have people telling me they do everything right. They do the SATs, they do affirmations, they even live in the end. pretty well, but there is that one thing that they still are doing too often, and it's looking at their counting time and thinking, oh, but how come they're not here yet? And even if you do everything right, in those moments when you look out there at 3D thinking, well, I'm still alone, I'm still single, they're still not here. In those moments, you are not living in the end. And it's okay to feel that here and there, seldomly. But it is not okay if you do that every day. Because your dwelling place, as Neville said, is the state that you constantly return to, that you most predominantly return to. And if you do this every day, so it means that every day you are conscious of the fact that they're not here yet. And your consciousness is your reality. Your consciousness is the only reality in your life. So if you are more conscious of the fact that they're not here, after all, they're not here, they're not here, they're not here, well, they won't be here. So you need to cut that out. You need to stop counting time and looking at 3D. If you really, really live in the end, you should get to a point that it does not matter. Time won't count anymore, and what you see in front of your eyes won't count anymore, because you will know for sure that it doesn't matter. Because you know for sure that imagination creates, feelings create. Therefore, if in your imagination you are already with your SP, you are already in that relationship, it's going to harden into fact. So when you look at 3D, instead of saying they're not here yet, or I'm not seeing any movement, number one, you do not see any movement until the very end. There are plenty of movements that happened, but you do not see them. You're not aware of them. So stop saying that there is not any movement. You do not know that. There's plenty of movement. You're just not aware of it yet. And every time you are looking at 3D, instead of saying, why SP is not here yet, or they're not here yet, or it's been 10 months, it's been a year. Instead of thinking this way, think it has not hardened into fact yet. That's all. The only reason SP isn't here today is just that it hasn't hardened into fact yet. That's it. Stop looking at 3D saying they are not here, because this is a huge pitfall for a lot of people that can't seem to be able to manifest their SP. And last but not least, number five, you are doubting the whole process. And doubt, unfortunately, is the enemy of manifesting. This is why in the Bible, which by the way, it's all about manifesting, right? It's all about the law of assumption. It says that when you pray, you must believe that you already have what you are praying about. This is a key element of manifesting. Whatever you are doubting, you're not going to manifest. So if you doubt the whole process, if you doubt that you can even manifest a specific person, well, that doubt is going to manifest in, you're not going to get it. So doubting, he's a huge no-no when you want to manifest anything, when you want to manifest money, health, a person, or anything else. Doubting it, doubting that you can have this, will manifest of you not having it. That's the law. I didn't create the law. That's law. And we have no choice but follow the law. Okay, we cannot make the rules of the law. We can manifest anything we want, but as long as we follow the rules. And the rules are, you cannot doubt. You have to know that you are God of your reality, and that as soon as you say, I want this, if you have zero doubt, it's going to come upon you like crazy. Because, by the way, a lot of people ask me sometimes, how long? Well, how long, nobody knows. Never even said that also, you know. The when, that's not our business. We don't know the when. But one thing that we do know, it's going to be in the shortest time possible. The law is not interested in giving you the longest way possible, giving you your desire in the longest time possible. No. The law is interested in giving you your desire the fastest possible, as fast as possible. But at the end of the day, it depends on you. Because if it takes a long time, you are doing it. So when you discover the law of assumption through the teaching of Neville Goddard, one thing that you learn very quickly is that you have to know that your desire is yours, and you have to know that doubt doesn't manifest desires. So when you doubt that you can actually have your specific person, well, you manifest that. You manifest that, well, you're doubting, therefore, it's not coming. So you have to cut that out, guys. You have to work on your faith, because the law requires faith. How do we master more faith? Well, by testing the law. Again, by going back into your life and remember how fast you manifested whatever you didn't doubt that you could have, whatever you didn't have any resistance about. And practice the law with smaller things, things that you do not care so much about, and see how fast you are going to be able to manifest them. This is going to build your faith. Also, read success stories. Read Neville. All those things together will help your faith, will build up your faith, and you will have less and less doubts. So guys, I hope these 5 points were helpful for you to understand, first of all, why you are delaying your manifestation of your specific person or anything else, really, and what you should do instead. If you liked the video, please show me that you liked it by giving me a thumbs up, comment, and share the video if you can, because so many people need to know those things. And subscribe if you have not yet. This will help my channel. And as always, I'll see you next time. Bye-bye for now.